Greetings, seekers of weird and wonderful cinema. This is the Vault of the Killer Bees, a place to celebrate genre films that lie just outside the mainstream. Films that are so bad they're good, and of course, the hidden gems. Now, this week, we're going to take a look at a movie responsible for one of the most iconic horror posters of the 1980s. And that's Ghoulies from 1984. Now, according to Charles Band, the director, the filming of Ghoulies went pretty well. There were no major incidents on set, no film exposure problems, and at the end of the day, they made a fun little creature feature film that filled the screen with creepy, cool, demonic imps, and those imps were designed by Stan Winston protege. That's Charles Band right there. He was the director of Ghoulies. The creatures were designed by Stan Winston protege, John Carl Buchler. Now, the only problem was, how was Charles Band going to be able to get interest in the movie and get butts in the seats, as it were, to go see this really great, fun little creature feature? For that, you'd have to come up with a killer, killer poster. Here's some of the Ghoulies right here. As you can see, they're pretty, pretty nasty little guys. Now, back in the day, when you had a poster, that was pretty much the only way that you could generate any sort of buzz aside from a trailer, because the posters were not only placed in theaters for the upcoming attractions, they were also published in newspapers. So you could go ahead and get a little bit of a teaser, as it were, for what was coming up in the next week or next month's releases of movies. That's the way you could generate buzz back then, before you had the internet and all that sort of stuff. So Charles knew this, and he knew that he had to generate some buzz for the film. So who could he go to launch a successful campaign? Thought about this for a while, and he called his friend Gary Allen. And then it turns out that Gary Allen had just finished doing a trailer. Well, had finished doing a trailer for a film that you might be familiar with. Star Wars Episode IV, the very first Star Wars. And of course, so that was very, very successful. So Charles Band gave Gary Allen a call and said, "Hey, I need help with a concept for the poster, and do you think you can help with the trailer too?" Gary Allen said, "Sure, let me take a look at the film, and I'll see what I can come up with." Gary Allen took a look at the film. A couple of hours later, he's like, you know what? How about we have one of these monsters like popping out of a toilet, okay? And then we can say the tagline, "They'll get you in the end." And Charles is like, "Oh, that's great," because Charles is so much of a P.T. Barnum of independent cinema. He's always about the buzz and the sizzle along with the steak. The only trouble was that throughout the whole movie, there were no scenes like that. No scenes of a monster popping up out of the toilet or anything like that. So how are we going to go ahead and tie this in to the film? He told Gary Allen about it, and Gary Allen's like, "Well, go shoot the scenes." And so, of course, Charles Band, loving the idea for the poster and wanting to capitalize on it, called up Charles Buchler again, bought a toilet, and in an afternoon, they went ahead and they had the scenes for the film that matched up with the poster. Gary Allen then cut the trailer, which received a G or a green rating That meant it could be broadcast for all audiences. And the rest, as they say, is history. Yeah, not quite. Since the trailer itself was general admittance, so it could be broadcast, for all sorts of audiences, someone turned out, actually, it was because it was broadcast for all audiences. Turns out the trailer itself was broadcast during the Saturday morning cartoon block. And of course, local TV stations across the country were inundated with phone calls from angry adults complaining that after seeing the Ghoulies, especially the scene of the monster coming out of the toilet, their kids would no longer be able to go to the bathroom or no longer enter the bathroom for fear of one of the Ghoulies trying to get them. Now, even after 40 years, Charles Band still gets fans coming up to him with stories about them double checking the bathroom before they went inside as a kid for fear of one of the ghoulies lurking about. Now, Ghoulies is a fun, great example of a truly enjoyable B movie. And if you haven't seen it, I highly recommend you give it a watch. And you know what? That's it for this week's Vault of the Killer Bees. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have, give us a like and be sure to subscribe to scififorme.com's YouTube page and turn on the notifications so that way you'll never miss another journey into the vault and where we go in search of weird and wonderful cinema.
Copyright 2022 by Flaming Dog Media, LLC. All rights reserved. No portion of this program may be retransmitted without the express written consent of Flaming Dog Media. You're watching Sci-Fi for Me TV, delivering the multiverse since 2009.